December 7th, 1941, a day of infamy. Even as Japanese diplomats were conferring with Secretary of State Hull on peace measures, Nipponese planes were swooping down on Pearl Harbor. This pictorial record includes both U.S. films and pictures made by the enemy as they dropped their load of death on the naval base, on Wheeler Field, on civilian homes and schools. 100 Japanese planes and a number of midget submarines took part in the attack. In an hour and 5 minutes, the battleship Arizona was completely destroyed and 4 others severely damaged. 3 other battleships and 3 cruisers suffered lesser damage. Nearly 200 planes were destroyed. In that Sunday morning inferno, the Pacific Fleet appeared to be completely immobilized by the sneak attack. Nearly 3,000 casualties added to the catastrophe. Within hours, the United States declared war.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The United States was at peace with that nation and, at the solicitation of Japan, was still in conversation with its government and its emperor, looking toward the maintenance of peace in the Pacific. Indeed, 1 hour after Japanese air squadrons had commenced bombing in the American island of Oahu, the Japanese ambassador to the United States and his colleague delivered to our Secretary of State a formal reply to a recent American message. Japan has therefore undertaken a surprise offensive extending throughout the Pacific area. The facts of yesterday and today speak for themselves. The people of the United States have already formed their opinions and well understand the implications to the very life and safety of our nation. With confidence in our armed forces, with the unbounding determination of our people, we will gain the inevitable triumph, so help us God. I ask that the Congress declare that since the unprovoked and dastardly attack by Japan on Sunday, December 7th, 1941, a state of war has existed between the United States and the Japanese Empire.
Japan proper, the USS Nevada and her escorts fight off attacks by kamikaze suicide planes. One wing blown off, a Japanese plane scores a direct hit. The Nevada, veteran of the last war, was in Pearl Harbor at this war's beginning and has fought in many major actions since. All that remain of the kamikaze plane are its wheels. The pilot is wrapped in the Japanese flag for his suicide mission. Casualties on the Nevada are 60 men dead, wounded, and missing. The carry destroyer Ticonderoga off Formosa sustains a near miss from another kamikaze. Succeeding enemy planes try for hits. Most are brought down. But one dives straight into the Ticonderoga. Envelops the ship. Pictures made simultaneously show the same attack viewed from the carrier itself. Luzon in the Philippines, as throughout the Pacific, a mighty dragnet tightens on the enemy. Except for a few last holdouts, the Japanese have now been driven completely from the Philippines. Those who still resist are destroyed, adding to the 450,000 Japanese killed in these islands.
We are gathered here, representatives of the major warring powers, to conclude a solemn agreement whereby peace may be restored. It is my earnest hope, and indeed the hope of all mankind, that from this solemn occasion, a better world shall emerge out of the blood and carnage of the past, a world founded upon faith and understanding. Let us pray that peace be now restored to the world, and that God will preserve it always.